soy Samuel y para los que no me conocen, estoy aprendiendo español. So it's not even close. The number one question people ask me when they find out that I can speak Spanish is, how can they learn Spanish? Although to be honest, it's not really a fair question because everybody learns differently. So to address that question, I'm going to answer it as though I'm talking to me before I knew anything about learning Spanish. Does that make sense? So I'm gonna talk to me 5 years ago, porque para los que no me conocen, por los últimos como 5 años más o menos he estudiado español. And I've learned a lot about Spanish, but also a lot about how to learn Spanish and what works for me. So I'm going to be talking to me 5 years ago, knowing what I know now, kind of the prescription that past Sam should be following to learn Spanish. And there's a chance it works for you, there's a chance it doesn't. So be sure to leave me a comment below if you had to go back to day one, what's one of the things in your routine that would get you back to where you're at?
And I forgot to mention that I'm gonna leave all the links of everything I talk about in the description below.
So I'm gonna break this into 3 major time segments. We're gonna look at the first 90 days. And honestly, the first 90 days are probably the most important because that's gonna be the foundation of the rest of the journey. That's gonna really set the pace for how long this is gonna take. And I promise, no matter what the videos, you know, in the sidebar say, it's gonna take longer than 90 days. If that's your expectation, you're gonna be upset. So we're gonna look at the first 90 days, then we're gonna look at up to the first year, and then what we should be doing 1 year and beyond.
And again, I keep saying we, but really what I mean is like me.
Okay, so for the first 90 days of the Spanish journey, what I would do, I'm gonna set aside 30 to 45 minutes a day, and there's 3 boxes that I have to tick every single day. First thing we have to do, YouTube. I would recommend to myself to find a Spanish-speaking YouTuber who's already uploaded loads of content. The fact that you don't understand them yet is less important than getting that input of the language every day. I would say for at least 10 minutes. An average of 10 minutes of video should suffice. But because you're not gonna understand what they're saying right off the bat, make sure to turn on subtitles and make sure whoever this content creator is, that they're either funny or interesting in some way or another. Easiest way though is probably just make sure they're attractive because you're gonna be looking at them for at least 10 minutes a day for the next 3 months. Second thing we're gonna do every single day, Duolingo. So Duolingo is a great place to start, but it's not gonna take you all the way, which is why we have 3 boxes that we have to tick every day. So every day we're gonna do Duolingo though, do at least 100 experience, whatever that means to you. You're gonna go through phases where you're gung-ho on all the lessons, you're gonna go through phases where all you wanna do are the stories, just whatever it takes. You're doing, after your 10 minutes of YouTube consumption, you're gonna do at least 100 experience of Duolingo. Now the third thing we're gonna do after we've already watched our YouTube video for the day, after we've already done our 100 experience of Duolingo, is we are going to listen to 1 episode from Language Transfer. So Complete Language Transfer, this is something I've actually already talked about before. It's a free audio course. There's conveniently like 90 episodes and they're all about 10 minutes long. No notebook required. This is kind of my secret sauce that's gonna take you from absolute zero to not quite hero, but well on your way.
Also, if you're saving your receipts for this first 3 months, it's gonna be grand total of $0.
All right, so it's now we're at the 90-day mark. You've watched roughly 900 minutes of Spanish content on YouTube. You have 9,000 experience on Duolingo and you've just completed the language transfer course from English, most likely, but maybe not, to Spanish on language transfer. We are looking at the next 9 months now. So every day we're gonna continue on YouTube. If you found your content creator that you really enjoy, that's awesome, keep watching them. There's a lot of great ones out there. Turns out Spanish is a pretty widely spoken language, so there's tons of people you can find. Keep watching a video a day, keep that habit. Now Duolingo, we're gonna keep doing that. If you don't like it as much, maybe drop down to 50 experience per day. If you found out that you really like the stories, for example, maybe bump it up to 150 experience a day. But the main thing is that we're forming a habit that you're gonna do day in and day out, because believe it or not, there's gonna be days that you don't wanna do any of this. And life is gonna get in the way. And if you let it, you're never gonna learn Spanish. So we're still getting on YouTube every day, we're still doing our Duolingo every day, but the third thing, now that the language transfer is gone, this is when I recommend we really need to start getting some output. This is when you can find a language partner on Tandem or HelloTalk. They're both fantastic apps, both totally free. You're going to have to swim around a little bit. You're going to find some people who aren't as serious as you. You're going to find some people who are way more serious than you. You're going to find some people who want to date you from halfway across the world. Totally normal. Just kind of swim through, find somebody that you can chat with. Personally, I prefer Tandem. I think the user interface is better. You can text people, you can voice chat, you can video chat. Find somebody, honestly, where you can get, like, I mean, at least 3 or 4 conversations in a week that you guys can schedule, where maybe you'll do 10 minutes of English. If they do 10 minutes of Spanish, the more the merrier. It's just going to speed up your process. It's right about this part of the process that most people quit, and honestly the next like 6 months are pretty boring, because up until that 1 year mark you're just going to keep rinsing and repeating and doing the same thing over and over and over again. But don't stop. I mean, if you really don't like it, then like obviously don't do it, but you got to realize that if you really want to speak Spanish, you have to do it. And if you don't do it, you just won't. So it's just kind of like what do you want to do more, you know? And that brings us to the 1 year mark. And this is that kind of plateau that a lot of people will get stuck at, because at this point, you know too much to not be able to converse naturally, but you haven't practiced it enough, so you haven't really earned it. And this is where we're still gonna keep doing YouTube. We're still gonna keep doing Duolingo, continue to reinforce all that, but this is where we actually have to get out there and speak. This is where if you're in a position financially to do so, italki teachers, I've only heard good things about getting on italki and having an actual tutor in Spanish talk to you at a scheduled time, once a week, twice a week, 3 times a week. Or if you want an even more casual approach, and sometimes nerve-wracking approach, this is when you can turn to online chat rooms like Omegle or Omi.tv. Omi.tv is actually a really fun one. I've made a ton of videos. I'll leave a playlist in the description below, because I have had a lot of fun. I've met a lot of interesting people and learned a lot about different Spanish-speaking countries, totally in Spanish, on Omi.tv. But these are processes that you start to speak, you start to get more accustomed to using the language, you start to remember little subtle nuances, and that is really where that 1 year, if you do this, if you write down, you're getting on one of these programs 3 times a week, 4 times a week, 7 times a week, this is really when you're gonna start to grow and get to that 1.5 year mark in Spanish and be confident, where you can bump into somebody in the grocery store who needs help translating something and you're ready to go. Or you can find that cute boy or girl at the bar and they happen to be Spanish speaking and you can knock their socks off. Or you can just leverage your new skills to get special treatment and discounts at your local Latino restaurant. That's always a good time as well. But that's the short of it, guys. If I had to go back, knowing what I know now, for the first 90 days, every single day, I would watch a YouTube video entirely in Spanish. I would do 100 experience of Duolingo, and I'd listen to a language transfer video. And then for the next 9 months, that's the long haul, where you're still watching YouTube, you're still doing Duolingo, and then intentionally try to have conversation with people on HelloTalk or Tandem. And then from 12 months and beyond, again, we're still on YouTube, we're still getting that input, we're still on Duolingo, reinforcing our grammar, reinforcing our conjugations, you know, really doubling down on Duolingo podcasts, but also intentionally conversating with people, whether it's on italki with a paid Spanish tutor, or maybe you're a risk taker living on the edge on Omegle, or if you want to get more of an appropriate experience, you're on Omi.tv. And I promise that in, you know, at that 18 month mark, you're really gonna start getting some solidification, you're gonna get some confidence in the language. But again, I'm just promising this to myself. So once again, please do let me know in the comments below. I love hearing about people's experiences. If you had to go back to day one, knowing what you know today, what would be one of the main components of your Spanish language learning journey? And I'll see you next week.